Well, after a very active finish to the day yesterday and spring-like temperatures, a very different picture today. We are looking at some filtered sunshine throughout the daytime today, and that's also coming with quite the cool down. As we look at our live super Doppler form, high pressure is briefly in control, and that's what's bringing in nice quiet conditions for the time being. But off to our west, we have a system that's going to build on in, and that's going to bring the return of some rain late tonight into tomorrow. Now, as far as our afternoon highs go, we went from 75 degrees at GSP yesterday to the 50s today. So quite the temperature drop for us. This is fairly close to where we should be this time of year. Normal high is right around 60 degrees. Now you'll notice over the next couple of days, we've got a roller coaster of temperatures. So today in the 50s, tomorrow only getting into the 40s, and that's going to come with widespread rainfall. So a cold, rainy finish to the work week for us. And then we jump about 20 degrees on Saturday, upper 60s Sunday, and then right near 70 degrees moving on into next week. So certainly going to see quite the temperature swings over the next few days. Now let's map out today and into tomorrow, as we'll start to see some increasing cloud cover as well as that chance for some showers. Now the rest of the afternoon looking nice and dry. Notice that cloud cover beginning to build on in. Once we get close to about dinner time and after sunset, that's when we start to see the arrival of some of these showers beginning to knock on our door. It doesn't really become more widespread until late tonight into tomorrow. So keep that in mind if you are going to be out on the roads on the earlier side tomorrow. We've got a few things we need to watch. That colder air starts to push on through, especially across western North Carolina. So 6, 7, 8 o'clock tomorrow morning, there is an opportunity where this rain will mix in with a brief wintry mix. Again, we need to watch that closely, because if that cold air sticks around too long, we could actually see some minor ice accumulation. For the time being, though, it looks to be short-lived. Elsewhere, looks to be mainly rainfall across the area. And then we're going to continue to see periods of rain on and off throughout the day on Friday. So yes, it's going to be one of those days where you want to have the heavy jacket and the rain gear ready, because we're going to see rain almost at any point in the day. Really can't rule out that potential. Yes, you will see some pockets of dry time, but as you can see, this moisture is going to be pretty steady as we close out the work week. Now moving on into Friday night and into Saturday, we're only left with a few spotty showers. So yes, you might be waking up to a few lingering showers early Saturday morning. Most of this should clear on out by midday. So we are going to see some improvements as the day moves on to kick off the weekend. But again, you might be waking up to a few showers Saturday morning as well. Now, as far as rainfall potential goes, all said and done, it's a fairly quick moving system, but it's likely to bring us a good amount of rainfall, anywhere from about a half an inch to an inch or more of rain, all said and done. So it is going to be a wet finish to the work week, and then we'll clear things out just in time for the weekend. So the 4-day looks like this. Highs in the upper 50s today. We are looking at nice quiet Thursday on tap for us before that rain becomes more widespread moving on into Friday. So we do have an impact day issued for Friday due to the rain and the chill that will be in the air. Then we'll gradually warm things up as we move on into the weekend and clear things out, especially the second half of the weekend. I would say Sunday would be the peak day of the weekend, highs in the upper 60s and nice and dry. Moving into next week, we'll start out nice and dry Monday and Tuesday, and we're watching for the potential for our next chance for rain by midweek.